we see first C2 and C3, second column and third column are identical. Therefore, the value of determinant will be equal to 0. And in third determinant, C1 and C3 are identical. Therefore, the value of this determinant will also be equal to 0. And here is 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 3, 6, 10. In expanding the determinant, we always try to make the maximum 0 in any row or any column. Then we have converted this C2 converted C2 minus C1 and C3 converted C3 minus C1. We get C2 minus C1. Here is AQ, 1 minus 1, 2, 3. First column is as it is, 1, 2, 3. Second column, 1 minus 1, 0. 3 minus 2, corresponding elements are subtracted element by any row or any column which has a number of 0. And here, R1 has the maximum number of 0. Therefore, we expand it by R1. Here, AQ, we have subtracted C2 from C1 and C3 from C1, and we will get 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 3, 0, 2, 7. Expanding along R1, we will get AQ 1, delete this column and this row. 1 multiplied by 7, 7 minus 3 multiplied by 2, 6. And the answer is AQ. And this is your theorem 5. Theorem 6. If any two rows are two columns of a determinant of a determinant A are interchanged, the value of A, get multiplied by a negative sign. For example, if there is a determinant 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 1, 6, 2, 3. And the value of this determinant after expanding along R1 gets 1, delete this column and this row, 6 minus 2, 4, 6 minus 2, 4, minus 2, 6 minus 2, 4. Minus 2, delete this column and this row, 12 minus 6, 6 plus 3, delete this column and this row, 8 minus 12, minus 4, and the value will be equal to 4 minus 12, minus 12, 24, 24 minus 4 is equal to minus 20. And if you interchange any two rows or any two columns, for example, we have changed R1 to R2 and R2 to R1, then we will get 4, 2, 1, 1, 2, 3, 6, 2, 3. And the value of determinant will be, after expanding along R1, this will become 4, 6 minus 6, 0, 6 minus 6, 0, minus 2, deleting this second column and first row, this will become 3 minus 18, 3 minus 18 plus 1, and deleting this column and this row, 2 minus 12, minus 10. This is your 0, this is minus 15, minus 15 multiplied by this 30, minus 10, and is equal to 20, and this has just changed. This is minus 20 and this is plus 20. This is your theorem 6.